Joining me live to talk about this is Senior Analyst at ASPI, Malcolm Davis. Hi there, Malcolm. Thanks for your time. So obviously this is not anything new, but I guess Australia is now taking a more active role in the naming and shaming of these actors. You know, do you think we'll see, I guess, a more multilateral coalition on deterring China's cyber espionage being formed?
Look, I think we need to do that. We have multilateral cooperation on defence and national security in the traditional sense. Well, now we need to have the same approach with new domains such as cyberspace and space. And clearly, here's an example of China using hacking technologies to attack our critical infrastructure by exploiting old computer networks that are perhaps being, or computer systems that are being used by individuals or small groups at home, and gaining access to our critical infrastructure. So I think we do need to work together with our partners and allies in the region to deter and defeat such attacks.
So who, what groups of people and businesses and organisations in Australia should be mostly aware of these dangers and try to do something?
Look, pretty much anyone that has a computer that's connected to the internet that uses it for work. And you know, too many people don't update their operating systems or don't have adequate antivirus protection and internet security software on their computers or their mobile phones. And so hackers, be they in China or be they elsewhere, exploit these gaps, these vulnerabilities, not to gain access to the computer per se, but to use the computer as a conduit into other networks that have far more valuable information. So if you're working from home for a company, Chinese hackers can get into your computer and then get into your company's networks and extract useful information. So really it's critical to maintain and update your technology and your antivirus and your internet security systems.
Now, what makes up China's hacker army are threefold. There's the military, there's authorized, which includes the Ministry of State Security and the Public Security Bureau of this APT 40 would be a part of. And then the civilian, which is much murkier and probably more dangerous. We're talking about businesses, investors, you know, civilians. So how should we counter, you know, this hacker army, which by traditional conservative estimates, maybe up to 100,000 at least?
Look, this is just part of China's approach to what it calls unrestricted warfare, where it uses all aspects of state power, including the civilian population, to wage, if you want to call it, people's information warfare. And it uses hacker groups as convenient non-state actors that it can exploit and mobilize. And these hacker groups can then work on behalf of the Chinese Communist Party to achieve CCP goals and objectives. What we need to do is work together as a nation and also work together with international partners and allies to counter these groups. And that means we need to invest in effective cybersecurity measures nationally and regionally to identify and defeat such groups. But I also think naming and shaming does help. It's not going to stop the hacker attacks, but it does shine a spotlight on them rather than giving them the benefit of anonymity.
I was trying to get a sense of Australia's cybersecurity ranking or preparedness. How would you rate it?
I rate it highly. I mean, we've got the Australian Signals Directorate, which is highly effective in terms of tracing these groups, identifying them, monitoring them. And remember, you know, when these groups are hacking, we're gathering intelligence on them. So, you know, it provides an intelligence opportunity for us to actually understand what they're doing, where they are, who they are. And I think that obviously we wage a defensive battle. We have offensive capabilities as well, but it's primarily defensive in our approach. And ultimately, that is an effective capability for the nation. But it will be more effective if we can work with international partners to actually have a regional response to China rather than just simply a national response.
Malcolm, how can we get people to be more aware of these dangers and, you know, to, I guess, foster this culture of cybersecurity without, I guess, fear-mongering or getting people into a panic?
Look, I think it's just common sense. if you have a mobile device, if you have a computer at home, which everyone does, then make sure it's properly equipped with cybersecurity software. So Norton's internet security or various different other brands that basically can help protect your network and just make it more difficult for a hacker to gain entry, and then from your computer gain entry to your work network. And I think so at the individual level, at the organizational level, it's just really important to inculcate a proper sense of cybersecurity and why it's vital that you protect your information.
Thank you so much for your time. Malcolm Davis from ASPI.